Welcome to Escape to the Country. Now, the rather scant ruins of this chapel overlooking that dramatic coastline are hailed as the birthplace of one of Britain's most famous saints. But who was he and where did he enter the world? Well, join me in just a moment and I'll tell you. On today's show, I'll be helping a couple up sticks and move to the country, so long as we head in the right direction.
So the choice is yours, that way or that way?
We'll go that way, shall we?
Right then.
And as our search gathers pace, it seems we're making headway.
This is the most excited I've seen you, Di, all week.
I love it. I love this house so far. I've only seen two rooms.
Well.
Today I'm in Pembrokeshire, and those are the remains of St Non's Chapel, overlooking St Non's Bay, reputedly the birthplace of St David, Wales patron saint. And just nearby is this St Non's Well, said to have sprung from the ground the moment St David was born in 500 AD. Now, for centuries it was thought these waters had restorative powers, and during the medieval period, both these sites were important waypoints for pilgrims making their way to St David's Cathedral, just a mile or so inland. But they're still popular today, with thousands of walkers who regularly take a trip along the Wales coastal path. The county of Pembrokeshire takes in the southwest peninsula of Wales. Its path runs 186 miles along its dramatic rocky coastline, which is also home to Britain's only truly coastal national park. The natural coves and wild beaches here have the most awards for environmental excellence in Wales. The enormous pebble bank on Newgale Beach in the west of the county was first formed during a storm back in 1859. One of the most magnificent castles in South Wales is Carew Castle, built in 1270 by Nicholas de Carew and still owned by the same family. Since 1995, it's been recognised as a site of special scientific interest. North Pembrokeshire is also home to the Preseli Hills, a landscape of wild heath and moorland, which is dotted with prehistoric remains and burial sites dating back to the Bronze Age. All these natural and historic features make this area a compelling escape destination for those in search of a true country retreat. Now, over the last 20 years or so, it's estimated that the number of people moving to Wales has increased by some 20%. And of course, that rise in popularity has also affected house prices. Currently, the average price of a detached property here is some £220,000. And if you throw a sea view into the mix, which is certainly possible here in Pembrokeshire, well, you could add another £15,000 to that figure. And, of course, as a rural county, it is awash with properties that come with that all-important ingredient of land, which is exactly why today's buyers want to move here. Steve and I first met 40 years ago when Di was working as a barmaid in a pub. Steve, a former HGV driver, retired 2 years ago, and Di, who currently works part-time, is planning to follow suit. They've lived in the same property for nearly four decades in the town of Eastleigh in Hampshire. But urban development and being apart from their ponies has prompted their desire to move to the country.
One of the main reasons we want to move is they are building more and more properties in this area. It's getting busier and busier. Our horses are about 4 miles away, so to take the horses out would be going through a housing estate, basically.
It's quieter, hopefully, in West Wales than it is here. It's very busy on the roads here now. The scenery and the lifestyle seems to be really nice and quiet. We have had a trip around and had a look around the area of the Preseli Hills, and they are beautiful.
The couple have a mutual equine interest. Di's been riding all her life and has two ponies, whereas Steve's involvement is more grounded.
I'm a national FEI, it's two-star course designer. For carriage driving, I go around the country designing courses and building them for the carriage driving fraternity. I've now taken up cake baking, which was a novelty for me, but I do like cakes and I'm making quite a few of them at the moment. That's why, hence, I am putting on a bit too much weight.
I'm excited about the move because I can have the ponies at the bottom of the garden and hopefully nice, safe riding.
This will be a particularly significant move for Steve, as it's his first ever.
I've lived in Eastleigh all my life. I was actually born in this property. It was my parents' place. Over the years, more and more properties have gone up around here. It used to be a quiet village. It's not the same as what it used to be. Want to get back to the countryside and enjoying ourselves with the peace and quiet like it used to be here many years ago.
As they've sold their property and are cash buyers, they're already halfway to making their move to the Pembrokeshire countryside. Our couple have previously explored the area around the National Park in North Pembrokeshire, but are happy to extend the search to Carmarthenshire. So I'm meeting up with them in Wales to find out a little more about the type of home they're looking for.
Well, Steve, I welcome to Escape to the Country. The goal, what we're all seeking, is to find you a home where you can have your horses at home, because that's not the case at the moment, is it, Di?
No, they're 4 miles away at the moment, so, and the traffic's quite bad, so getting up there takes a while.
So I guess the dream would be to be able to open your kitchen windows and have your ponies outside the house.
Absolutely, absolutely. Yes. Absolutely.
Or maybe open the patio doors and have them walking in.
Well, hopefully not quite that extreme.
So give us an idea of the sort of property that you're thinking about, because let's face it, whatever it is, it's going to be very different to what you've got at the moment. It is.
Yes, well, it's going to be, we prefer something with at least 2 bedrooms,
yep.
Detached, rural, but you know, not too far from a village. Kitchen diner.
Yeah.
Yeah, and Steve wants his man cave.
Can I have a man cave?
Yeah, well, absolutely. We all need one of those, mate.
I can always build it if we can find a plot that we can actually build a man cave in. Somewhere I can disappear.
But in terms of the horses, how many acres do you think you need for your two?
We prefer anything from 3 to about 12 acres.
Yeah. Anything else I need to be aware of?
Some sort of holiday lip potential.
Oh. Okay, just another one in there.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, holiday lip would be a little income.
Now let's talk about the budget. How much are you going to spend on this move?
Maximum budget's £450,000. But we'd like the property to be all nice, laid out for us, exactly.
And done. I'm quite excited, really, and we've got a fantastic week of weather ahead of us. I mean, look at that. Yeah. You know, that's just a taste of what's to come. So we've got three to show you, including our mystery house.
Yep.
Ooh, what's that going to do? Yeah. Let's go shopping. Come on, follow me.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Steve and Di have £450,000 to spend on a 3-bedroom home with a large kitchen diner. They need on-site stables and land for Di's 2 ponies, a workshop option for Steve, along with a possible holiday let, all not too far from a village. With their property sold, the clock's ticking. Fortunately, we have some really enticing properties to show them. I'll be asking them to guess the price of each before I reveal it, and our final stop will be the mystery house, which could push the boundaries on style. Our first house is situated on the edge of the village of Camrose, an area popular with horse lovers. The nearest amenities are just over 4 miles away in the traditional Welsh village of Roche. St Mary's Church in the heart of the village lies in the shadow of the imposing castle. Once a royalist stronghold, it's now a luxury hotel, which on a fine day can be seen from our first substantial proposition.
Ah, look at all this behind us. Yes. And have a look at that, because that is our first property.
Oh, very nice.
Very nice.
Yeah?
Very nice.
That's the old bit, all right? Classic bit of Welsh architecture, really. Mm. But as you can see, much improved and much extended to now give you 4 bedrooms.
All right.
4.
Yeah, yeah. Lovely.
And a fabulous master bedroom that's up there.
Mmm, with a balcony.
With a balcony, and there is sense in that because it overlooks that. 7 acres of flat land for you.
Oh, beautiful. Oh,
beautiful.
Absolutely.
I reveal that to you now because I think it's important to get the land issue out the way. Mm-hmm. I think this is very amenable, pony paddock.
It is.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes, most definite.
It does come with man shed.
Good. Good.
Okay. Are we happy, Di?
Yes.
Very happy.
Very.
Very happy.
The oldest part of this south-facing farmhouse dates back roughly 300 years. The current owners used stone from the same quarry when they extended it 20 years ago. We're starting in the original part of the property.
All right, come in, Di. Come in, Steve. There we go.
Oh, beams.
Yeah.
And it's quite high as well.
Unusually so, actually, to be honest. You would not perhaps expect a ceiling of this height looking at it from the outside. This reception area is something of an L shape. It goes through there.
Right.
You could have that as a bit of a study area, but they've actually got a dedicated study through that door.
Oh, right. Yeah.
Yes.
Cosy room.
It's actually, yeah, but it's roomy.
It's roomy.
It's quite a lot of space in here.
It is. Very nice.
And it's nice to have the feature stone walls.
The staircase here goes up to three bedrooms above us. Okay, there is a separate staircase in the new extension which takes us up to the master bedroom, which we will explore in due course.
While Steve and I seem impressed with the character and space down here, upstairs, those three bedrooms consist of two doubles with lovely deep windowsills, as well as a generous single with a built-in bed. There's also a stylish family bathroom, but now to the extension.
This is the new addition to this property, of course. Right. Again, double doors that you saw from the outside.
Absolutely.
Lovely views of the ponies.
Yeah.
Yes.
Countryside.
Yeah. And then your kitchen is through here. You might need to duck a little bit.
Yeah. Not me.
Over there. There you go. Nice sort of freestanding look to it. Thinking the ponies are going to be here waiting for breakfast.
They're going to be right up to the door if we don't put a fence up. Yeah. But yes, very nice kitchen.
Very nice kitchen.
Yes.
Sit here and have breakfast. Look at that.
It's a shame the sink's not facing that way, really, isn't it? Well, perhaps not, really.
Well, then you wouldn't have the doors, would you? You wouldn't be able to get out. Are we envisaging a moment when we could see your ponies out there?
Oh, yes. Can you see them out there?
Oh, that's going to be a big shed out there.
You've got one over there. You've got one.
Next to the kitchen, there's also a shower in the utility room. Steve's itching to get back outside to see his potential man cave, but I've got a couple more rooms upstairs in this newer wing to show them.
Are we all coping with stairs after bungalow living?
It's yes.
There we are.
Oh.
This is the master.
Oh, very nice and roomy. Oh, very. Look at the beams.
Yes.
Very nice.
Shower ensuite through there. You did ask for two bedrooms, but we've got four to play with, so, you know, you could lose one
Absolutely.
Comfortably.
Oh. Yes, with a balcony.
Mm. Wake up to that in the mornings.
Mm-hmm. Want to have a look?
Oh, yes.
There you go.
Oh, beautiful.
Out you come, Steve.
Look at the view.
Absolutely lovely.
I mean, it's a great spot to really see what you might do with that 7 acres.
There's loads of space to play with.
You can see why I wanted to start with this property.
Absolutely.
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, I hope the others live up to it.
Well, we haven't finished here yet because we do need to discuss the price. Let's go down there.
Okay. Come on.
This lovely rural property meets their brief in so many ways. So let's turn our attention to what they think it's worth.
So, Di, go on, make me an offer for property number one.
Very nice, brilliant views, lovely paddocks, 435.
I was going to go a little bit lower than that. I was going to say 375.
375?
Gosh.
Wow!
Ever hopeful.
Wow! Where does he get his optimism from? Because I want some of that. I'm afraid Di is much closer. This could be yours for £425,000.
All right.
OK.
Yeah. Yep. It leaves us money for stables and
absolutely. Go on then, off you go. Go and have a wander around and I'll catch up with you a little bit later. Go on.
Okay.
£25,000 under budget, this traditional stone farmhouse of two halves has four bedrooms and a large kitchen diner. There are 7 acres of well-drained land, perfect for Di's ponies, and there's even that requested workshop for Steve.
The house is very pretty. I do like the master bedroom with the balcony out, looking over the land and the views. Very nice.
It's very quirky and it's completely different than what I'm used to. Crown and Glory will be the land. It's very nice, flat. All we need to do is build some stable blocks for the horses. But yeah, it would do quite well. And the view, of course, is spectacular.
What a cracking day for viewing houses. We have spoilt you with the weather.
You have.
We really have. And I think we have spoilt you to a certain extent with property number one.
Yes.
Yes, definitely.
However,
beautiful.
There are more to come.
Uh-huh.
More houses and more acres to see. Come on, let's go.
of the Preseli Mountains is the Dyfed Shire Horse Farm. Once a working Welsh farm, it's been breeding shire horses since 1849 and is now a rural tourist attraction. The Shire is a draft horse which became popular because of its incredible strength and gentle character. It was once a familiar sight, pulling drays and working the land, but it's now a rare breed with around 1,500 left in the world. Mindful of their enthusiasm for all things equestrian, we've sent Steve and Di to meet farm manager Mark Cole, who's carrying on the tradition first started by his great-grandfather.
In the late 19th century, early 20th century, they worked the land, we ploughed the land with them, they were the animal that helped feed a nation at war, and they more than did their bit with my grandfather and my great-grandfather here on the farm up until 1962.
Mark's grandfather missed the horses so much, he decided to reintroduce them to the farm when he retired, this time as a hobby. 25 years on, the farm and his shire horses are still going strong.
Well, Di and Steve, I know you have a great love for everything equine, and we have an opportunity, if you're interested, to meet Katie, our farrier, who is now around the corner in the stable going to shoe one of our large shire horses. You're more than welcome to watch us at work.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mark. Thank you.
They're going to watch a four-year-old shire, Willa Rose, have a new set of shoes made for her by Katie Johnson, one of a handful of female farriers working in the UK. Shires are one of the largest breeds of horse, so naturally they don't have standard-sized horseshoes. Theirs are made to order. Katie knows the 10 horses so well, she's memorised all of their hoof sizes.
Why did you decide to become a farrier?
I decided to become a farrier because I wanted to help horses and I couldn't find a farrier for my own horse when I was a teenager. A shire horseshoe is typically made from flat steel. We have to hot shoe them to allow us to shape the shoe itself, and all the shoes are made from scratch for each of them.
Is it very difficult to shoe them physically?
Yeah, shire horses are much heavier. A small one, you're looking at 600 kilos, but the biggest one that they've had here weighed 1.1 tonnes. And shires don't always need to wear shoes. If they're just in the field, or they're brood mares, or they're young stock, they won't typically be shod unless they're going to a show.
Willa Rose regularly pulls visitors in the cart around the farm, so with her new shoes fitted, it's time for Steve and Di to take up the reins.
She should listen to you. She is
Willa
very
Rose,
good.
Rose, walk on.
Good
girl. That way, thank you. Good girl.
Road, we're crossing the border into Carmarthenshire for our second property, situated in the hamlet of Cumbach. Local amenities can be found 4.5 miles away in Llanboidy, which has a village church dedicated to the 5th century saint, Brynach. Back in the rural hamlet of Cumbach, the next property used to be a working farm. It has an ancient bridleway beside it, perfect for our buyer's ponies, but let's see what their owners think.
So as you can see, a very different proposition, property number two, to our first one. Let's just pause here and take it all in.
It's completely different than the last one.
And the house itself perhaps needs a little bit of TLC and really make it your own. Mm-hmm. Now, needless to say, the holiday let idea, I think, really surfaces with our second property because of all these buildings.
Yes.
You can see around you.
Very nice.
I love it.
Very nice.
I absolutely love the yard, and the house is absolutely gorgeous from the outside.
Yeah. And very peaceful again. Yeah. Can't wait to get inside.
Yeah? Yeah? It is going to take a little bit of imagination.
It's fine. Okay.
Yeah, let's go and have a look. Come on.
The array of outbuildings previously had planning permission to convert them into holiday lets. Although it's now lapsed, it set a hopeful precedent for our couple. And the house itself is all ready for the new owners to call home.
So as you can see, dining room with window seats.
Oh, yes.
And then, fittingly, next to the kitchen, which is very different to what we saw in our first property, this one being much more of a kind of galley arrangement, yet still with some lovely features, you know, the stone walls, the slate floor.
And the beams, the light beams.
And of course, you've got those views out to the more formal garden that way.
Yeah, it's not a bad Wits kitchen, is it? Though it's a galley kitchen, there's plenty of room, and I love the range.
Yes, oil-fired, that one. There's also, through that door at the back, another utility space.
Fantastic.
So it is different, guys. Yes. I mean, what's really going through your minds?
I have to get my head around to how to work it, but, yeah.
The flow of this building is quite interesting. We can go that way through to the living room, or you can also get at it through the dining room. So the choice is yours, that way or that way?
We'll go that way, shall we?
Right then. There we go. So this is kind of cosy time, really.
Yeah. Well, it's not that cosy. It's quite a large room.
Quite a large room.
Yeah?
Yeah.
But I'm thinking of an evening, you know, settling down.
Absolutely. I think it's quite a nice-sized room.
It is.
But, you know, the key thing that I look for is, does it have the bones, you know, to mean that it's genuinely got a sense of potential? And I think it does for what you are looking for.
Yeah. I think it does.
The main living area we've just seen lies at the centre of the property. But the downstairs also benefits from a study and ground floor double bedroom, which could give options for additional holiday lets. There's also a sunny conservatory with views over the garden. Upstairs, at the front of the house, the master bedroom looks out to the courtyard. Beside it, there are another two good-sized doubles, plus a single being used as an office. On the opposite side of the landing are two options for bathing, including a state-of-the-art shower room. It all sits in its own substantial parcel of land, amounting to an impressive 5 acres, which we're going outside to explore, along with an abundance of outbuildings.
I mean, more man sheds than you ever know what to do with, Steve, surely?
Definitely.
The prospect of having all this at your disposal, is it a bit overwhelming, Di?
It is a little bit. Yeah. There's a lot here.
But as you can probably see in here, you've got farming going on all around you, but that's the metronome to your rural life, you know, it's great.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah.
And you and your animals can share in that. Mm. Let's go and look at those acres, and then we'll start talking about the price, shall we? Come up here. The bulk of your pony paddock is there. Yeah?
Yes, yeah.
Big enough?
It is big enough.
This little wired off area here, which has now got some young lambs in it.
Yes.
And then behind that boundary is the lawn that's outside the kitchen window. So you have got pretty good views all the way around you.
You have.
So, you know what's coming next, Steve?
The price.
The price, exactly.
I was out on the last one by quite a long way, so I reckon this one is round about the same price as the last one, although this one needs a lot more work. So I would say 420,000.
420,000, yep.
I'm going 410.
410. A little more optimism from your wife this time, I think, Steve. In fact, your husband is closer to the mark on this occasion. Interestingly, this is comparable with property number one. This is £425,000.
Okay.
So I think lots for you to weigh up between the two properties that we've seen today. Don't get too lost, and I will come and find you later on.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Brilliant.
This well-proportioned 5-bedroom farmhouse is £25,000 under budget. It has outbuildings galore for the workshop of Steve's dreams and stabling for Di's ponies, as well as holiday lets, all wrapped up in a 5-acre plot.
That's a duck. This could be ideal for conversion.
Absolutely. And you could use it as a feature of the floor.
It'd be a bit of a challenge. Never done anything like it before, but the prospects are there. We'd have a go.
The house is absolutely beautiful from the outside. The rooms are all reasonably good sizes. The kitchen, though it's a galley kitchen, is very nice and wide, and plenty to work with in there.
The outbuildings do appeal to me. A big Dutch barn at the end, which we can convert to stabling for the horses. The other one for hay. And it'll still leave me one of the barns there to do a conversion for a workshop. Big project. But a bit at a time, we might still be able to do it.
All done?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I've been enjoying, well, it might be your house, who knows? Who knows? But I think a good day so far, yeah?
Yes.
Yep.
Yeah, good been interesting, isn't it?
Very interesting. We've learnt a lot and the sun's still shining.
Well, it's still hot.
Very hot.
Which means we need to head in the direction of something cold.
Correct.
See what I'm thinking? Come
Let's
on.
Go.
It's the second day of our property search in Pembrokeshire with Steve and Di from Eastleigh in Hampshire, who have a healthy cash budget of £450,000. Coming up, we're pushing the limits with our mystery house.
Are we still at 10?
No, 11.
11? 11, OK.
And I learn what it's like to really live life off-grid, with no bills.
I mean, wow is not enough, is it? That is absolutely astonishing.
Now, so far, on paper, our first two properties definitely fit the bill, as far as Steve and Di are concerned. But worryingly, I'm not detecting a great deal of enthusiasm. Clearly, they want to move from Hampshire, but I just don't get the sense that they're particularly passionate about property, and it's that passion that I look for in any set of buyers. So what can we do to reverse the fortunes of this house search? Well, of course, we've got one more to come, and that is our mystery house. Now, here's a clue. It's not in Pembrokeshire, but it is in Wales, of course. It's just up the road in a part of the world that, for me, represents a real trip down memory lane. I'm going to love seeing it. I just hope they do too. So, guys, I get the feeling that despite having seen two, I think, quite interesting properties yesterday, we've yet to get you closer to a sale. Is that fair?
They haven't quite felt right to me.
Can you put your finger on it? Or are you struggling to really nail it?
Struggling to nail it, to be honest, but...
Can you help him out, Di?
Well, one of the things when you walk into the house, you usually get a feeling, oh, this is nice, yes, we could live with this, and it feels like home.
Yeah.
Didn't quite get that feeling yesterday. Both houses were nice, both had little quirky elements to them, which were interesting, but just not quite there.
We're staying across the border in Carmarthenshire for our mystery house, situated in Llanabadda. 6 miles away is the busy town of Lampeter, which has a lively local community and a farmer's market. It's full of cafes, shops and artisan eateries. The area is also well known for its textiles, and the town is home to the Welsh Quilt Centre. And back in Llanabadda, there's a newsagent, a 10-minute walk away from our mystery offering.
Right, here we are, the entrance to our mystery house. Now, it's pretty enough from here.
Absolutely.
But come through the gates. Right, guys, come over here. You get another aspect of it there.
Lovely. Very nice.
So, you've saved the best till last.
I think we have saved the best till last. Why is it our mystery house? Well, as you can probably tell, it is almost certainly the biggest property we've had a chance to show you. This entire package offers you lots and lots of options, because not only have we got this very, very lovely house, we've also got you 8 acres.
Oh, lovely.
Lots of land to explore later on, OK?
It's beautiful. I love it. I love the shape of the house.
What about you, Steve?
I can see a shed.
There are plenty of sheds as well.
I'm happy, and the house really does look nice.
Lovely.
Fantastic. Can't wait to see it.
Now, in fairness, it doesn't have a huge kitchen diner.
OK.
I'm going to just put that out there,
yep.
And we'll deal with it when we get to it.
We are open to compromise.
Come on, can't let's wait. See what you think.
The original part of our 4-bedroom mystery house dates back to 1819. The current owners added the kitchen, which we're exploring first.
Little kind of boot room and utility area there.
Yes.
And then this, Di,
aha,
is the kitchen diner.
Right, very nice.
Yes?
Actually, I do like it. The size is okay. You've got quite a decent sized table in here.
Yeah.
And you've still got space. Yeah, I love the range.
Yes, you see.
I like it.
Yes.
Even though the roof's low, yep, it doesn't feel low.
No.
So am I right in thinking then that we've overcome, perhaps, the kitchen diner issue?
Yeah, I think so with this one.
Yeah.
Yes.
Thank goodness for that, because my problems are solved now. The rest of it will sell itself,
oh, good.
I think.
It's clear that room size isn't everything. It's also about how a place makes you feel. And so far, I think they feel very much at home.
Now, how about this?
Nice size. It's beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. And I've just spotted the log burner.
Yes, you've got the log burner there. Lovely texture to this. You know, the beams, the stone, the wooden floors. Really cosy.
Beautiful. Nice outlook.
This is the most excited I've seen you, Di, all week.
I love it. I love this house so far. I've only seen two rooms.
Well,
got the feeling.
That little magic sprinkling of property gold dust. Yeah. If you love this, you're going to love what's upstairs.
Exciting.
Yeah.
Let's hope they feel the Midas touch in the rest of the mystery property. In the other half of the house, leading off the entrance hall, there's a study and a ground floor double bedroom, along with a shower room. Upstairs provides another spacious double bedroom under the eaves. This part of the house, with a few alterations, could make an ideal two-bedroom self-contained holiday let. On the opposite side of the house, a separate staircase leads directly from the living room to another large double bedroom on the first floor, which has a spacious ensuite bathroom, all beautifully renovated. But I'm taking Steve and Di to see what they think of the master bedroom.
I think we're spoiling you with this one.
Oh, yes.
Now look here.
Wow.
Look there.
Oh, beautiful. Amazing.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I mean, that puts the fun into an ensuite.
It does.
Not just tucked away, you know,
in
a corner. They've made something of it.
It's gorgeous.
And it's all been done.
Yeah.
10 out of 10 so far.
10 out of 10 already.
Already.
Before I even asked you the question.
And I haven't seen my sheds yet.
Wait till you get outside. Yeah, well. Should we get outside and have a closer look at that land?
Yes, absolutely.
Please. Yes, please.
The
clincher.
Come with me. Come with me.
I can't wait for them to see outside. The gardens are absolutely stunning, but what I really want to show them is this property's crowning glory, its land, which I think will blow them away. As well as the 8 acres of paddocks, there's a workshop, a wood store, a garage, and an additional storage shed.
Right, guys, come up into this paddock. There you are. Take all that in.
Absolutely beautiful.
It's a lovely view.
Beautiful.
It's lovely. And the paddock is beautiful. It just dips away slightly to allow the view to expose itself. It is lovely.
And, of course, there's another one over there.
Yeah.
And there's another one over there, you know.
Absolutely gorgeous.
Are we still at 10?
No, 11.
11? 11, OK, well. So let's get into the prices then. Any ideas, Di?
We're definitely over budget. I'm ever hopeful it's about 465.
A hopeful 465, yep.
I'm going to say around about the same.
Well, here's the thing. I can make your wish come true because this is on the market for £450,000.
Right on budget. You got your book?
I'm going to get my chequebook now. No problem. Perfect.
It is beautiful.
Absolutely perfect.
Steve, you're a bit choked.
I am. I'm really choked. I am.
Take him away. Take him away. Give him a moment on his own. Go on, get over there into the sunshine. And I will come and find you a little bit later. Well, there you go. Property buying can be an emotional business, as Steve and Di have just found out. I'm often asked, how many of the properties I see on this show would I ever buy? Well, to be honest with you, I can be as picky as the next person. But in this case, yes, I would buy it.
Bang on budget, this stunning four-bedroom mystery house has been immaculately renovated and extended. Lying in 8 acres, it has everything they want, including a potential holiday let and plenty of workshop options for Steve. All they need to do is move in.
You're right.
Yeah, I'm fine.
Good.
I think that's it.
Found what you're looking for, or what we're looking for. It is beautiful. Views beautiful. Wherever you look.
Absolutely. The quirkiness of the house, the extra bedrooms, they all just seem to work. It just, it's a complete package. The house doesn't need anything done. It's got this little bit of quirkiness. It's just perfect.
It's taken me by surprise how lovely the area and the house is. Even down to the colour of the house, I would never have thought about looking at a house this colour. But as soon as you walk in, you've got that warm feeling that this is where you want to be.
Is it fair to say we finished on a bit of a high, Steve?
Definitely high.
But we have given you, I think, a good range on our whirlwind tour of Welsh properties. Yep. Time now to sit down and mull it all over, I think, Di.
I think so.
At the eastern end of the Preseli Mountains near the village of Crummock is Lammas, Britain's first self-sufficient eco-village. It's a pioneering architectural and environmental blueprint, which started 8 years ago and is currently home to 13 families from all walks of life. All the houses on the 76-acre site have been built by volunteers and the families themselves using local, natural and recycled materials. I'm meeting one of the co-founders of Lammas, Hoppy Wimbush, to learn how it all works.
Now, the whole thing is clearly organic, yeah, in terms of the materials you're using, but they in themselves obviously dictate a form of architecture which I'm finding refreshingly different.
Yeah, well, it's very harmonious, isn't it? You know, it naturally flows, it follows natural lines of the wood. The average cost of building a building here is, you know, anything between £10,000 and £20,000.
I mean, that is virtually a tenth the price of the average detached property in Wales. And it works.
I know.
There will be a queue of people stretching down this mountain to the coast, I would think.
For me, moving into a home that I've built myself in a natural environment, it's transformed my life. And I feel so connected.
It hasn't just transformed Hoppy's life, it's transformed the land, which used to make £3,000 from farming lamb and now generates over £100,000 a year from its produce and activities. I'm dying to see inside one of these homes. This one belongs to Marianne. It was one of the first to be built here.
Oh my goodness me.
Thought you might like it.
I mean, wow is not enough, is it? That is absolutely astonishing.
It's quite unusual.
I think the form, every bit of timber relates to its neighbour, gives it such an original feel. Mm. Is this typical of the kind of buildings that are here?
It is unique. It is its own flavour, which is reflecting the person that built it, really.
I mean, it's a very warm, cosy place to be. I mean, in terms of your bills, are they virtually zero?
So all our electricity's free, all our water is free.
Well, I mean, we pay into the hydro system if that needs maintenance, but yeah, it's directly run by us.
I'm absolutely blown away. You know, I see lots of amazing country properties throughout any given year.
But never anything like this.
This absolutely, you know, is at the top of the tree, literally.
Every household at Lammas derives at least 75% of their food, fuel and income from roughly 7 acres of land. The residents use permaculture techniques, a process of farming designed to reduce the impact on the planet.
I mean, effectively, you've created, on what was presumably an empty hillside, your own kind of walled kitchen garden, haven't you?
Exactly. It's like rebuilding the biodiversity here. And that's what's so unique about this way of farming, because it's about relationship with the land, direct relationship with the land, and whilst being very, very productive, also looking after nature.
I mean, looking at all these materials, all this lovely seasoned wood, for me, it's like gold. You know, I'm itching to get my hands dirty and get involved.
Well, it's funny you should say that. I need some help with something. Would you be willing to give me a chance?
Yeah.
Fantastic.
All the electricity is generated by solar panels and a micro hydro turbine.
So, have you ever sanded using power tools on solar power?
I have never used a solar power tool. No, I really haven't. I mean, it's great, though.
If you can take off this edge all the way along this timber, and then we can use that as a work surface.
Just lightly feather that in. Well, Hoppy.
Ha-ha. Thank you very much. You've done a lovely job of this.
So eventually this will go in there with a sink in it.
It will.
Now, talking of power,
yeah,
where's the kettle?
Let's go and put it on.
The Welsh Government have introduced a national low-impact policy called One Planet Development as a framework for eco-village projects to be established in Wales and the rest of the country. I certainly look forward to seeing this incredible concept spread all over the UK.
Well, as you can probably see, we've set Steve and Di up in the sunshine with some tea to talk about everything this week has thrown up. But to be honest, I don't suppose it's been a very long conversation because, no surprise, there is clearly only one contender. The big question is what happens next? So, let's get down to business, shall we? There is clearly one major contender. I think we all know what that is, but our mystery house has certainly set the fire alight, hasn't it, Steve?
It has, definitely. Very, very nice property. 10 out of 10 for that one.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Perfect. Perfect.
Perfect. Oh, perfect.
So, come on, Di. What happens next, then?
I think we're going to try and go back for another visit. And then it's back home to work out the finances.
You said at the Mystery House that it just had that special feeling, but what was it that suddenly made it work for you?
I think the layout of the house, it seemed to flow really nicely. It had the little annex, which is something we was hoping for, didn't think we were going to get. And it just did, it had the right feeling.
As soon as I walked through the door, it just felt right. Strange, I know, but...
But now you've experienced it, it is true, properties do grab you, don't they?
They do. That one did, straight away.
Were you surprised?
Very surprised. To be honest, I didn't think we'd find anything and we'd have to carry on looking, but the Mystery House has done it again.
Well, guys, it just remains for me to wish you the very best of luck. I hope the second viewing goes well. And please do let us know how you get on.
Absolutely. We will do.
Thank you very much.
Yes. Here's to you. Cheers.
Thank you, cheers.
Well, sadly, our time here in Pembrokeshire and West Wales is now coming to an end. As you can probably see, the tide behind me is out, but surely Di and Steve's property ship is about to come in. When we set out this morning, I wanted to see more passion for property, and they didn't let me down, helped in no small part by a fantastic mystery house, which, let's face it, certainly sold itself, not just to them, but also to me. I'll see you next time. I'm pleased to say Steve and Di did put in an offer for the Mystery House, which was accepted, and they should be moving in soon. We wish them and their ponies the very best in their new Welsh home. If you would like to escape to the country in Wales, Scotland, Northern Ireland or England and would like our help, you can apply online at bbc.co.uk/beonashow.